Hi, my name is Idra William, and today I'm going to talk about LORs, Letter of Recommendation. So this is for all the international students, dentists, and doctors who are applying to programs in the United States. And before I do that, I have two things to mention. First of all, in my last video, I asked if you want me to do a webinar or a YouTube live to answer most of your questions. You could mention that in the comment that you're interested, and you need to also mention your time zone. So I need to find a time zone where it's suitable for me and for you to go for a YouTube live or a webinar and have discussion. Secondly, the disclaimer is about the letter of recommendation. The information and the knowledge I'm sharing is not coming from any individual or any institute or any official. It's coming from my own experience that I observed and I have learned through people who got into school and also who didn't got into school. So this is my perspective and my experience that helped me get 4 admission acceptances in 4 different dental schools. So coming to LORs, what are letter of recommendations and why they are required? So a lot of schools in the Western society require you to give a letter of recommendations to find out whether you're a credible person or not. So how do they do that? They ask you for a personal statement. They ask you for a resume. Then they ask you to get your degrees and your diploma authenticated by an organization. And along with that, they will ask you to give them letter of recommendations. And in those letter of recommendations, my advice is you would, if you've done like 15 to 20 things in your life, you've done your undergrad, you've done research, you've done residency, you have done some kind of postgrad, if you have done volunteership, preceptorship, you want to figure out amongst all these things, which is the most valuable, which is the most, I would say, significant thing that you have done. And once you figured that out, you would like to highlight that thing in your personal statement, in your resume, and then support it with your LOR. For example, in my instance, my strongest thing I thought was that I've done some part of residency in oral and maxillofacial surgery, and I do want to share that. So my first letter of recommendation was from my dean, who also happened to be my supervisor in oral and maxillofacial surgery. So in my one LOR, I was able to provide the information that not just I was a dedicated and good student in my undergrad, but along with that, I was also a person who was trying to pursue higher education and had a dedication in advancing my skills. And so I was able to provide 2 things through one letter of recommendation. Secondly, my second letter of recommendation was from a professor from my master's program, master's in health administration, who also happened to be the CFO of Mission of Mercy. So how I was able to kill 2 birds with 1 stone is that my professor was able to write that I was a student of his doing the master's program, and I happened to be a good student, dedicated one, and along with that, he was also able to share his knowledge that I was volunteering with Mission of Mercy as a dental assistant, and what values and what attribute did I bring to the institute. So through this letter of recommendation, I was able to authenticate 2 perspective of my resume or 2 abilities that I have. And I was able to support more information. And the third one that I provided was from a dentist in United States that I shadowed. So that kind of helped that the things that I was mentioning in my personal statement, the things that I was portraying and explaining, that I have experienced dentistry and seen dentistry firsthand, and I've learned in United States, those were the things that were actually I would say supported by the letter of recommendation written by that American dentist. Along with that, these were the three letter of recommendation, but along with that, I also asked professors of mine from undergrad who taught me orthodontics and who taught me restorative to also write me letter of recommendations as a backup. So my main priority was to get a letter of recommendation from people who could express my strongest side. And my strongest sides were my residency and my undergrad, obviously. And the second thing to it was my master's program and my volunteer. So you want to find opportunities where you could express dual sides, or I would say more than one side. You want to project that you're not a unidimensional individual and you're a well-rounded individual. And that's something you want to look into. And I would say if you're looking for, if you haven't done a lot of work, if you haven't done volunteer work, if you haven't done postgrad education, first of all, start doing stuff, start working, start building your resume, start improving yourself, start volunteering. Because in order to get good letter of recommendation, you need to have experience, right? You cannot have a letter of recommendation without doing anything and sitting at your couch. So first of all, move yourself and orient in doing something useful. So when I was applying to schools, my perspective was getting letter of recommendation from individuals who will not just authenticate my academic or my professional performances, but also tell what kind of person I am and what kind of attribute that I hold in my personality. And in order to accomplish that, you need to build a relationship with that individual, that he would be able to authenticate and tell something personal about you. And that's something which makes your letter of recommendation of, I would say, higher value, if that person can mention something which is personal between you and that individual. So I think in order to get a good letter of recommendation, the first thing is that you need to move yourself, get yourself out of the couch and do something. You have to go and accomplish some activities. You need to have 5 to 6 things that you have done in your life, and out of those 5 to 6 or maybe 10 things, you need to figure out which one are the most important. Was it the volunteer work that I done with Mission of Mercy? Was it the volunteer work, or was it the preceptorship? Was it the research or postgrad residency? And once you figure that out, then you're going to figure out, if my postgrad residency was something very important, I will try to get a letter of recommendation from that platform. And from that platform, you need to realize who would be the best person to write me a letter of recommendation. Usually, the dean of your dental school, getting a letter of recommendation from that individual is a necessity. That's essential. So you cannot play around with that. That's something that has to be done. But after doing that, you want to look for individuals from the platform where you feel you have done the most stuff. So that's one criteria. The second thing is you want to keep a mix, a combination. You want to ask people who could show different sides of your personality. If you worked in United States, if you work in India, if you worked in Dubai, if you worked in other places, you want to have letter of recommendations which will show that you're the same person with very well-rounded side, and you're a very I would say well-adjusted human beings. And this is actually presented by a supporting letter from US and from Pakistan, from India and United States, from a volunteer platform like a non-profit, and from a dental hospital. So just imagine if a pastor from a church is saying that you're a good person because you did a volunteer work, or a letter of recommendation you're getting from a dentist who's saying you're a good person, then you're and a good dentist. And then thirdly, a professor is saying he's a good student and a good person. Well, it shows that you're one person with a very good perspective from all angles. So that could make you even very well-rounded as well. The other thing with letter of recommendation is the bigger the umbrella, the better. So the bigger the organization, I feel that's more authenticated, it holds more value. If the organization is recognized internationally, that's better. And if it's recognized in the United States, that's also good. And after that, if it's only recognized in India, Pakistan, Nepal, Bangladesh, Saudi Arab, or in Middle East country, or South American countries, then it comes later on. But I would say rather go for organizations with bigger umbrellas and more recognized reputation. In addition to that, one other advice that I would give is include some part of volunteer work as well. My core theme throughout my personal statement and through my resume is that my ability to pursue and strive for success in a way that improves me and improves the people around me. And I've been saying this over and over again. And for me, in order to prove that, I had to put in something from a nonprofit organization as well. And that's where Mission of Mercy came in. And I think that supported me, especially in case of University of Indiana. And I'm mentioning this, that University of Indiana last year actually asked all the candidates to give one letter from a dean and a dentist, and the third should be from a nonprofit organization where you volunteered. So this kind of synced along, and actually that was, I think, one of the reasons that got me interviewed at University of Indiana, that I was talking that I like to do volunteer work, and along with that, I was able to support it with proof from a professor who was also a CFO for Mission of Mercy and also a professor. So you want to find stuff, you want to know your central theme. If you're talking about you're a person that is dedicated to research, then support it from a letter of recommendation from a researcher. If you're saying you're a clinician and you're a really strong and dedicated practitioner, you want to support it from a letter of recommendation from a practitioner. So it kind of varies from individual to individual. And I feel if you keep the essence of your story or the core thing that really makes you exceptional and support it, that will make you, I would say, more individually strong. So I'm just sharing my story and my perspective, and I hope this makes more sense. And I'm planning to do a webinar and a YouTube live. I've mentioned this earlier. I would encourage you, if you want to be a part of this and you want to ask questions, you can mention your time zone in the comment, so I would know in what time zone you are, and I could plan up something which goes along with my schedule and yours. And hopefully I will see you in a more meaningful video in the future. Do subscribe to the channel and do like the video. Thank you.